A wise man once said, "Character is what you are. Reputation is what people think you are. You must have both in equal measure in order to succeed." Started with some wheels, an internal combustion engine, and a sense of the future. The adventure mixed us with people. It took us to places and exposed us to ideas that have changed the way we look and listen. Today, for example, laser spectroscopy is a routine exploratory science. Change is a way of life, and life is acquiring a new viewpoint. We have enhanced our regard for solid-state physics and the new challenges this presents. A perfect product is a reasonable and inalterable goal. There is always an intricate series of tests under simulated conditions. We have learned never to mistake industry for accomplishment. The GM Technical Center is more than a laboratory and a promise. It is essentially a bank, not of money, but of curiosity, patience, and educated scientific skills. Are cumulative, far-reaching, and creative. What starts as one event may trigger a whole series of plus and minuses that span the spectrum of our interests. In a Kokomo, Indiana furnace, silicone is heated and nurtured until it produces crystals. When it cools into large cylinders, it is thinly sliced to become the basis for electronic logic in automotive circuitry. Luck is the residue of design, and we are very fond of luck. Gary Tibbetts tells us of his discovery.
We first grew these graphite fibers completely by accident. In following up this discovery, we learned how to produce strong, stiff graphite fibers by pyrolyzing natural gas at temperatures far below those required by conventional methods. Eventually, these fibers may be used in tennis rackets or golf clubs or automobile parts. Graphite fibers have always been strong and light. We hope to make them inexpensive, too.
Initiative goes without saying. We provide the tools of hope and companions in progress. Then we wait. Results come at their own pace. Motivation comes from desire and the ever-present conditions of competition. The game is hardball. As professionals, we recognize that it's a game with extra innings, extra technology, and alert coaching decisions. Our GM Science Advisory Committee consists of men from prestigious positions in both universities and other industries. At regular intervals, they take time from their routine work to provide us with direction and report new findings of their own. Excellence is worth pursuing for its own sake. On the practical side, the newly developed process called MagnaQuench, produces a powerful magnetic material that will finalize as an ingredient in smaller, lighter, and more efficient motors. The many moods at our campus-like tech center are not fleeting. They are integrity, commitment, education, artistry, change, grace, and sometimes noisy laughter. We have sought and found extraordinary individuals. Some work most effectively alone, like determined distance runners. Down the long halls, there are also team players who enjoy the international community of research. And there are also those who cannot be categorized. They have found a place to practice their degree specialty, a place to demonstrate their special talents. The bank of technical know-how pays interest. The ripples of information flow back and forth from promise to production in a system that can only be described as checks and balances. Kokomo, Indiana is one of America's foremost sources of integrated circuitry. The explosive and continuing needs of our industry create an unquenchable demand. We can't control GM curiosity, and if the truth were known, we don't want to. At Delco Systems in Santa Barbara, the lightweight Magic 5 is the latest in a series of high-performance microcomputers. It has its potential in advanced missile and aircraft systems. This hemispherical resonator gyro, derived from the ringing wine glass principle, consists of three main fused quartz parts with metal joints and thin film electrodes and conductors. It is an advanced navigator in a strapped-down configuration. It incorporates a military standard for flight control and weapon delivery. We are constantly seeking the ability to design, engineer, or utilize systems and products that will vault us into the future. The environment always gets top priority. In the spray paint booths, where Corvettes get their personality, we have employed the services of Pseudomonas possimopolis, a mutant bacteria. Their purpose? To consume the leftover solvents. The little bugs not only get their nutrients from the paint, they multiply in the environment while they keep our booths clean. It is, in fact, bioengineering, clean and efficient. In the foothills of Thousand Oaks, California, there's a nest of dreamers who are quietly but steadily projecting their thinking into the year 2000 and beyond. In this advanced product center, there are few rules. The only barriers are self-imposed. The facility provides the opportunity for young and experienced thinkers to monitor future technical, social, and aesthetic trends, then convert them to concepts without the restraints of time and habit. We have designed and built devices and hardware that pierce the barriers of space, ride the ocean's waves, and cruise the surface of the moon. But that was yesterday. If you are curious, you must have courage, mental and spiritual. You must have the grace to occasionally fail and we understand that. It does not blur our vision of the future. We are stubborn and sometimes emotional. These are human qualities. They do not discourage our sense of enterprise. Ours is not a 9-to-5 world. The galloping progress of the computer has altered our viewpoint, as it has all mankind. Now we conjure up miniature dreams and design them on cathode ray tubes. Along with others, we have raced into the electronic world, moved with genuine authority and some astonishment. We are less amazed than we are busy. We are consistently moving design processes from white acres of drawing boards to the dim lights of computer-aided design. We have created the controls for a system that keeps a cable-laying vessel as stable as possible at sea. By testing the whole system on computers, we are certain of its performance long before the ship is launched. We can readily anticipate a variety of marine action even before it exists. That engineer is on the bridge at sea while his feet are on dry land. We can design a solid part and test its stress points years before it is machined and produced. We can simulate unusual conditions of heat, cold, altitude, and vibration in a chamber watched and studied completely by computers and lasers. We can light an automobile and study its lines from every angle without ever turning on a light or building a car. It's all make-believe, but it leads to reality. We do not hesitate to invent materials, programs, and processes. We scour the world for what we need. When we don't find it, we create it, then build it in-house. This remarkable aerophysics range fires simulated re-entry missiles at Mach 25. The complex volley of monitors that measure it see it only for a millisecond, but the useful data streams back to the defense community. It is sometimes called the fastest gun in the West. Our world of electronic production is not entirely neat, but it is always precise and fully tested. It is actually an ever-changing series of circuits, diodes, and semiconductors, each with its own purpose and mission, each exposed to trying test conditions. Mission is one of those buzzwords of the 80s that has its own meaning in the modern world. It doesn't necessarily imply travel or even danger. It does suggest purpose. It indicates goals to be reached and may even imply deadlines. A constant mission in our business is an awareness of the environment. All the while, we are teaching and learning together. We make certain that all our devices are user-friendly, that our people are sharing what they know. Coaching is the right word for it. It should be mentioned that we also build automotive vehicles for the world, cars and trucks by the millions. Automotive products are carefully engineered to operate under all weather conditions, They carry a variety of loads over any type road. They perform for a myriad of drivers who have unique habits and personalities of their own. As time comes our way, vehicles will be more electronic, more responsive, more comfortable, and more reliable than ever before. A car has few redundant systems to protect it in the clinches. It must be fail-safe. Competition in the marketplace is always with us. We have built our reputation not on raw materials or gadgets, but on the principles of participative organization. Not on machines, but on the character of our human beings. We like that character. Courage, wit, and wisdom are all needed to lead the revolution that is rolling now and will inevitably arrive in the years ahead. We have the true grit to enjoy the romance of yesterday, the vitality of today, and the anticipation of tomorrow.